Welcome to Politics Watch. This is Herbie. Now today I'm going to be talking about the incident that took place on Lincoln Avenue. If you haven't heard or seen the video, let me just say this. You know Jamaica is going in the wrong direction. Right? Continues to go in the wrong direction. Because not like something new. When you see a lot of videos and pictures from various crime scenes and you tell yourself, so well, that's going to be the worst thing I'm going to see this year. And then something constantly come out, right? If you tap it and tap it and tap it, and you ask yourself, what kind of dopey show this? Jamaica is not just a Netflix series. Jamaica turned now a dopey show, because this scene, what happened to them two brothers? This is the worst thing I've seen, right, all year. I'm going to go into some details, tell you who they are, where they're from, and how they end up losing their life. Right. As for the video, I'm going to put it on Patreon, but I just warning Patreon squad from now, if you know your stomach is not very strong, don't even bother clicking on the video. Right? Just I give that warning from now. Now, the youth them come from Cockburn Pen. The one you see on your screen right now, he's the actual 87. His name Anif. Well known, right? Mix up not the badness. But here's the thing. This youth link with Birdman. Right, yes, the same Birdman that we talked about before. You see, the madness has been going on for a long time. And Birdman is actually taking a lot of losses. Come on, listen right now. Birdman, how many of you listen? And don't worry, I'm not ready to tell the people about the silly little stunt you tried to pull the other day. But that's for another day. So, this youth, let's see on your screen. Link with Birdie, when a Birdie look at 87 them. Now, it look like say, somebody never sent him the memo. It's a Lincoln Avenue switch up from Birdman. Because up until about January, right, anyway, when the big triple murder did go on, right, before that, man could have passed through the place, right, ends out, whatever. But after that, man didn't want nothing to do, right, with Birdie or any 87 then. So this dude end up get tricked, right? They blew him up there. End up losing life. Now me gonna describe to you what happened to him. And you tell my part, because obviously me can't show you. People, what me tell you say? The youth entire head. I'm gonna give you the visuals in the head. Everybody know what an egg look like, right? Egg where you fry or scramble, whatever. You know when egg drop and broke? And then you pick it up back, and all you pick up back is the shell and everything, right, the yolk, right, and the whites up on the ground. That is exactly what happened to this youth. As a matter of fact, as the police them pick him up and put him in a van back, let's just say the whole of the egg yolk, right, and the whites are drop out as them are carrying. Yeah, it's as grimy as it sounds. That's why I say Patreon squad, if you don't know, say, man, stomach not too strong, nobody watch the video, but I'm going to do a separate video showing, man, how the police, man, have to end up dealing with some of these situations when I pick up their money. Man. But anyway, this youth was 87, this youth was the target. Anif. Typical 87, love box up people, love bother people, things that make out the iron. Well, he's no more. The next brother I'm gonna show him right now. Him name Yashin. Now he's the perfect example of why you should not par with 87s. Look on your screen. This is Yashin. Now this youth is a baller, right, as in a footballer, that's what he's known for. very popular youth in the community. He's known for being a cha-cha boy, right? Like party, enjoy himself and all them things. But him and Anif afar. Anif, who is not just a known 87, but a 87 were hot in the streets. So, you know, so when the man them go for Anif and him there, you know that go already. Them now go say, well, we not really after you, so you can't go on home. And so it work. So the man them end up mash up Yashin as well. And before me I talk about with the egg and the yolk and whatever, the eggshell, exact same treatment. The eyeball a bulge out and all kind of things. It's a grimy scene. Grimy scene. Me say people my cut burnt when a ball theme. You know if you understand something. Me don't know which fantasy world people live in. What tell you say? Not because you don't necessarily mix up in something. You can just up and down pan roaded man, right? With deep in the badness. When them enemies walk up on you, there's not going to be no differentiation. There's not going to be no alright. Well, him known as a baller and a girlie, so him can go on. But him that's not how it work. Nobody not in a character reference for you. Nobody not say, hold on, I could check him. I could call down a criminal records office to see if my 87. Right, hold on, man. Nobody shoot him. I could not it work. This youth, talented baller, probably a bright future ahead of him. Guess what? Him gone. And the state where I see them in there, on the ground, and at the back of the police one day, them family now go, them have to go lock them casket there. I don't know how far the technology. I know say you have some good money work in the morgue and in place so we can put man back together. But I tell you, I'm fairly sure they have to go lock them casket there. All because I'm a par with the wrong man on the wrong day at the wrong time. So no theme family in the morning too. The place at. You know there's probably going to be some kind of retaliation. But Lincoln Avenue, the way them side there. Place tense. And me say. Birdman. I take some serious losses. Over the last couple weeks, the man just a wipe out the whole 87. Anybody will link with him? Man, just I get rid of them. Use them now, learn. Now, learn at all. Stay away from bad company. Nobody feels so because oh, you old man, them when I go to school or I know him from around the block. Brother, hi and bye. And I sit down in a car, right, with the 87. Right, I'm not gonna, don't even ask me for walk you got the shop, brother. Me give you the directions and you go on by yourself. Because you see what happened enough time. You might have a bridge in there, you know, say I'm a lock strap, so I'm go up on a one mission. But or you might know say I'm do things, but you don't know just how hot him really is. So you're a powered man, right? And he might look over for him show every minute, cause him know say him well at. Right. And you did it, through your several, you know, you might be a baller, or you might be a youth at 9 to 5, so you not have the instinct for you look over shoulder every minute, because and you had boy no matter when they come for, you know. The man them deal with them wicked. I tell you, Jamaica turn a Netflix dopey show. Some of these scenes, right. Only when time, way back in the day when time, you know, the group them from the Middle East used to release some videos. I saw Jamaica all them. But like the old time video them used to come out of Mexico. Broad daylight. Woman did that video, people can't believe what they must say. Anyway, before me end the video. When you look on your screen right now. What you're looking at is a mini protest that take place, right? Central Kingston. People them say they want a Zozo. When I say mini protest is because I don't think more than 5 people there. Right, the video is on the Jamaica Greener YouTube channel. People that say give us a Zozo. People that say them tired of the madness. But again, only 5 people there. And that's just what we could have seen, 4 or 5. Now, I have to come in, those people. It look like it's mostly females and mostly big women that age. Because you know you don't find a young girl at any place, especially in a Kirstine, you don't find one in place. But like some big women, including some people who look like them lose loved ones in the madness. I said they want as those that they want the government to take action. They want the government to be proactive. It's a shame they even have to say that. I mean, people shouldn't even need to tell the government, say, please be proactive, do something, right? But 4 or 5 people, come on. In our community, we take so much losses. This is what I don't understand. We keep hearing the narrative say, in a quote unquote Batman place, the 87 and the 90 are the people's best friends. You know, them love them, give them treats, put on treat every year and all them things, right? Them love the poor so much, them love the people. That's the narrative, right? And the people them can't stand and hate the police because, you know, the police is the biggest enemy, right? For people in a Batman place, right? That's the narrative. The police just wake up in the morning, go target random people down a Batman place, right? Just say, I could just go down to Central Kingston and go just shoot somebody. Right? That's the narrative. I could work with it, no? But just explain something to me. Since police is what the people am really afraid of, and since police is the biggest threat to the people in inner city communities, how people manage to find the strength and the courage for protest against the police at will? If a policeman sneezes too hard, the whole community come out. But the police is the biggest enemy, right? Police is the biggest threat. Now, the 87s and 90s in the community, you know, good man, bad man. When a time for protest against them, we should cheer 4 people. And when they say, what do we say people them there? Them say, but sure, people afraid. Why would you be afraid? If you're afraid of them, that would destroy the narrative. That means say, you're not seeing the police as my biggest threat. That means say, you're not afraid of police like that. That means say, a gunman you're afraid of. See, we know that narrative is nonsense. We know Jamaican people not afraid of the police. We know that. We know people are not going around with their knees trembling, saying, boy, I'm sure what I'm walking to some police. We know when Jamaican people wake up in the morning, be brushing teeth and put on their clothes and I walk out of their house, they're not thinking to themselves, boy, I'm walking to some police on the road, you know. God, boy, I'm so afraid of these police officers. We know that's nonsense. That's the narrative that's been pushed by various agents in the media, and agents in the entertainment, people with a big voice. We know they're agents. We know some people at Central Kingston, people at Larristan, people at Tredegar Park, people in Norwood, people in Salt Spring. We know say, the reason why the law-abiding members don't come out, come really protest and burn out 87s is because they're afraid of the said 87s. And the reason why people are quick off the boat but protest against police is because they know say, after them don't protest against police, they can guard them yard go sleep safe. Team of police now come back, come say, well, when you just protest against it, all right, we are going on every house and kill everybody now. Them know that not gonna happen, them know that for a fact. That's why them quick off pick up a sign and hold it up against police. But they will not hold up a sign, say, burn out Klansman, they will not hold up a sign, right, and say, J-Bad, if you dead, they will not hold up a sign and say, Nevada Hodges, right, if you get killed now. They will never do that, because they know, say, if them do that, also we get running pan, buckle boom fling in there, pitting everybody gone. It's a fake narrative. But what the agents do is them use the cases where, because obviously There have been many instances where police officers overstep them boundaries. Police officers even go as far as to carry out conjugates. So we know that these elements exist inside the police force. Nobody not deny that, that's obvious. But what the agents do is take them case and then use that and try to see it. This is why the people, no. As bad as JCF may be, as corrupt as a lot of the members in the JCF are, we know, say, if you ask the average person in a quote-unquote bad man place, who then rather run certain joke with, let me tell you, say, the police every single time. Let me tell you, say, JDF every single time, because after them cuss them out, fling stone off of them, fling nappy off of them, they can go back to them home in a one piece. So when you see them protests are going, 4 or 5 people. When I time to protest against the criminals, it's 4 or 5 people. Remember the Jasmine Dean protest? How much people turn up for that? 4 or 5 people. Wanna see the trend? But your favorite agent voice is so big, that's when them say, man. And people are here for so long, people genuinely think say Jamaicans, especially Jamaicans in inner city communities, are like terrified, right? And like the police is the biggest beast and monster, right, that exists in Jamaica. That doesn't make sense. Because if that was true, and you can gather the strength for protest and come out and call out the biggest beast in Jamaica, the biggest monster that you're so afraid of, then a lesser monster, like the little gang them in Central Kingston, right? Like Don Stokes, like 5150, surely you would also wouldn't have a problem with protest against them, because they are a lesser beast than the JCF, right? I mean, I'm just trying to make sense out of it. I must say, I'm not going to school, right? And I'm just a little YouTuber trying to make up things to get views, so somebody explain it to me. Police are the worstest thing on earth, but people, right, can get up in large numbers, right, to protest and burn them out. But the tiny little puppy, which is the 87 and the 90, nobody can get a strength to go say nothing to them. Or even video them when they go up on them apps or whatever. I mean, I just find it strange. Because they best believe, even though 5 people, you see, and 5 people think so, enough people in these communities want to see more police. Enough people in these communities want better operations, want more proactive operations. It's just that them nah and them can't come out come say it, because them know what gonna happen to them. The narrative is a complete fraud. People in these communities want to see more police presence. Don't listen to the kerosene that tell you the police need to leave. No, they need to, those are agents. That is their job. Highlight every mistake or screw up, because let's face it, security forces screw up enough time. Right? Highlight and blow it up, put it in the press, and say, see, that's why we don't want no police on here. Then, when police hear that, when Jamaican people see that, now pressure come down and then police back off, them 87 man them can go do what they want to do. It's the only trick in the book, but people still have fall feet. Anyway, people in my Central Kingston need security. Ghetto people need protection. Can't help themselves. Matter about the one they may not related to the Don, no. Matter about the one they may not when they're with no bad man, no. Proactive. That's the only way security forces can deal with these gangs. Sit back and wait till this and that, it not gonna work. But remember, the call have to come from the top. Don't ever forget that. Anyway. Patreon squad. Big up on myself, look out for that video. Follow Charlie off this one. PIA, you don't know, more life. Ultra squad, my known always are circling. Good luck finding some scraps. Bless.